legend of the vault. My father would always go on about the vault, even with his dying breath. Advanced alien technology, infinite wealth, fame, power, women. So you can understand why some little kiddos who hear the stories grow up to become vault hunters. Well.
With Gearbox and 2K's newest epic RPG, Borderlands has finally arrived. To start things off, Borderlands is one hell of an RPG. There's tons of missions to do, and tons of areas to explore with either yourself or friends. Set to take place in the wasteland of Pandora, you are greeted by a mysterious voice that tells you very little and forces you to trust her. Immediately, you are greeted to the bandits and the hellish wastelands that is this planet. You are then introduced to Zed, one of the main characters in Borderlands.
Attention, citizen of Firestone! There is no cause for alarm! This new visitor has resolved the problem!
To summon up Zed, well, there is no real way to summon up Zed. He's a very freakish doctor, but he offers plenty of quests for you to do to keep you occupied. To start things off, we have Mordecai, the hunter, with this pet bird, well, hawk I should say, who does quite the damage. After that, we have Lilith, a very sweet talker of that. She has pretty much just the phase walk, but is very dangerous, of course in cover. Then we have Roland, the soldier, Mr. Turret Man himself. And then finally, we have the big man in the back, Brick. Brick, well, to summon him up, he likes to punch things, and who can blame him? He's a monster. The game does a good job of making you feel like a single person. What I mean by that is using cover in certain spots is the difference between life and death, such as ambushes, or just waves and waves of big enemies. When you do die, you will enter a bleed-out stage, in which you have to kill someone before you bleed out, turn what's known as second wind, which becomes very useful in very high impact situations. The game's quest layout is very easy and user friendly. When you're doing a quest, a hub of where you're going and what it is you're doing is always displayed, and if you get lost, a map will show you the way. The graphics are cartoonish and very sketchy. The game can shine with its interesting art design, but it's no Call of Duty. Shadows can be a bit pixelated at times, but it's nothing that's very bothersome and won't stop you from playing the game anytime soon. Guns, guns, and more guns. Borderlands has a bazillions of guns to choose from. Hell, it even says it on the back of the cover of the damn game. Along with guns, there are skills, and each one helps you increase your character's best abilities, such as Mordecai's pet hawk, Bloodwing's damage increase, or Lilith's ability to use her phase walk for a longer period of time. There are also vending machines placed nicely around the map that allows you to buy weapons, ammo, or even health packs. Another very useful thing is the vehicles. Vehicles that allow you to tear through the wastelands in style. Vehicles also have infinite ammo, which is very useful. Also with vehicles, there are waypoints that allow you to return to previously unlocked areas. The game does an extremely good job of keeping you interested with treasure chests, boss battles, and traps set by AI that, if you're not defensive, could be very deadly, so make sure that you're always on the lookout for any suspicious areas. Multiplayer in Borderlands is very fun and easy to access. You can hop in with a friend and hop out without ruining your game or his. There are things such as power leveling, which takes about 3 hours to do, arenas and duels that will allow you to see who truly is better, but due to the modded weapons in Borderlands, the gameplay has become a bit unfair and very, very annoying. but there are still tons of people playing it, so it'll be very easy to access. Borderlands is a very well developed game. Fun gameplay, missions are long, multiplayer is very innovative and well played. It's just what every shooter/RPG fan ever wanted.
See you next time!